It's well known that alcohol affects our ability to drive. It's a major road safety issue. Drink driving is decreasing, but the incidence of drug taking and driving is on the increase, and the effects are little understood. So the Transport Research Lab is assessing the effect of illegal drugs, in this case cannabis, on driving.
We're looking at cannabis because we've just completed a 3-year study of drugs in fatalities, and we found, compared with a study we did 10 years ago, there'd been a massive increase in illicit drug use by a factor of about 5 or 6, and the majority of that illicit use is cannabis.
It's a sophisticated protocol, a double-blind, placebo-controlled crossover design.
Well, we first used a double-blind trial because this first means that the participants didn't know what dose they were receiving. The double element means that the person giving them the dose and anyone else associated closely with them in the trial also didn't know what they were receiving. Thereby, they couldn't contaminate them in any sense by influencing them in some way.
In one trial, they were given a placebo, which looks real, but has the active ingredient in cannabis, called THC, removed.
The placebo-controlled element is very important because people know they're part of an experiment. They are being given something, they don't know what they're being given, they're going to maybe react in a particular way, they maybe think they're getting something. And if they're giving them nothing and they still react, then this might look like an effect. So you do want to compare them against giving them nothing.
The crossover design gives another level of control.
The crossover trial, in this context, was used because we wanted to bring people in to give them 4 different doses of cannabis. People vary hugely between themselves and vary less within themselves, particularly with the sort of activities we're involved, driving type activities, other laboratory experiments. So we want to control for that source of variation. We want to reduce the variation. So we use them as their own controls. And to do that, we bring them in 4 times, and we call that a crossover trial. The participants were allocated to 1 of 3 groups, the groups being defined depending upon the dose order. In other words, participants in the first group might have taken a placebo on the first visit, the low dose on the second visit, and a high dose on the third visit. Participants in the second group might have started with the low dose, and participants in the third group with a high dose, for example. Choosing participants for this sort of trial, it's got several tricky elements. First and foremost, we couldn't afford to use people who are naive in terms of smoking cannabis. Use of naive people would be totally inappropriate. They have to be users, basically. But of course, cannabis isn't, or smoking of cannabis, or the possession of cannabis at least, is an illegal act. So you're looking for people who, on a day-to-day basis, well, at least a weekly basis in our terms, were conducting an illegal act. That's slightly tricky in terms of finding them. You can't just put an advert in the paper or something. So what do you do? Virtually everybody you know will know somebody who probably uses cannabis. So that's the sort of route we took. And you think, from the ethics committee point of view, that would be completely acceptable?
They'll want to see the way that we propose to run the study, you know, who's going to be smoking what and when, and how we're going to monitor it. They're going to want to see that we're taking some safeguards to ensure the health of the volunteers, making sure that they won't come to any harm from smoking. But I mean, they shouldn't do, because they're already smoking the stuff.
The researchers also screened participants to prove they were regular cannabis users and were not taking other illegal drugs. Once selected, participants were monitored over the course of the experiment.